Hello, and welcome to the second installment of Ask the Editor. I'm Steve Hedlund, the editor of SeafoodSource.com, and I'm here with Jamie Wright, who's the associate editor of Seafood Business Magazine. And we're here on the cold and windy Portland, Maine waterfront at New Meadows Lobster. And it's, I guess in Maine, as long as it's sunny, it's a beautiful day, so. Our question this week is, Jamie?
Well, we got this question from the Twitter account of Dustin MacInnis. He's a commercial fisherman, a lobster fisherman in Antigonish, Nova Scotia, Canada. And it's a pretty simple question. He wants to know what the price of lobster is going to be for LFA 26 when the fishery opens on May 1st. So we're going to try to speculate on what the price of lobster will be this season.
All right. And just as background, LFA stands for Lobster Fishing Area, and it's 26 in the southern Gulf of St. Lawrence, I believe.
That's correct.
Between Nova Scotia and Prince Edward Island. Yeah. So, really, there are four factors at play here. And one really big one is the economy. And as Jamie put it in a January 2009 Seafood Business cover story, really American lobster is the seafood industry's poster child of the global economic downturn. It just, demand hasn't been quite the same in the past 2.5 or 3 years. The export market for Canadian lobsters isn't as strong as it used to be, correct?
That's true. And lobster prices have suffered both in Canada and Maine. The last couple of seasons, Maine lobstermen have resorted to selling fish out of the backs of their trucks, doing anything they can to boost their sales and prop up demand for Maine lobsters. And it's worked. I don't know if it's brought the price of the lobster up to where they really want it, but it certainly has. They've done all they can to expand the market, and they're doing some other things that we'll get into in a minute.
Right. And one of those is the currency or the exchange rate. And where was the Canadian dollar at today? I mean, it has appreciated significantly against the dollar over the past few months.
Just in the last 2 weeks, it's gone up about 7 cents, I think. This morning, it was about, I think it peaked at 104 yesterday. So I think it was at $1.03, which is usually not good news for Canadian seafood exporters who rely on the U.S. market.
Right,
heavily.
By far the number one destination for Canadian lobsters is the U.S. market. So obviously, and I spoke to Jeff Irvin, who's the executive director of the Lobster Council of Canada, who told me that really the exchange rate has been even a bigger impact on Canadian lobstermen than the economy itself, which I thought was interesting. You always think it's all about demand, but really, Canadian lobster exporters aren't getting what they used to for their product. So,
and it's unfortunate. The supply picture has never been stronger. Mm-hmm. Last year's Maine lobster landings hit 93.4 million pounds. It's a record. Unfortunately, it's only the third highest tally in terms of dollars, $308.7 million. And in Canada, last year's landings were 125 million pounds. It's another strong season for them. So supply isn't really the problem.
Because the resource is as healthy as it's ever been, but basically you're looking at 25% more product on the market than there was just 5 years ago. And that, supply and demand alone will do that to price. So there's also rising fuel and bait prices, which are just really squeezing fishermen, and not just lobstermen, but all fishermen, not only here in the United States, but worldwide. And basically, Jamie, what I think is happening is to compensate for rising fuel and bait prices, lobstermen have to catch more,
and that's
keeping prices low.
But they're also, as we're going to talk about right now, they're working on new product forms. And that's really boosting the market and helping them out quite a bit.
Yeah, exactly. And just a quick quote from Jeff Irvine. In Canada now, the processing sector accounts for over half of the value. And we've seen a shift in the last 2 years from the live market to the value-added market. And the live market was really always the dominant market, as he says. And now the processing sector is producing more value, and you're seeing a lot of innovative products. and that's also a good thing too, because as the price has dropped significantly, it has opened up all these new market segments that were always out of reach. Because you know, as you were saying earlier, lobster is still viewed as a luxury item, but now it's seen as an excellent value.
It can be, and especially you know, the United States seafood industry is in Maine here. We're getting more into new product forms. They've rescinded the lobster mutilation law that prevented seafood companies from selling lobster sections like tails and claws. So that market is opening up too. And Canada has dominated that forever. So.
Right. And so finally, getting back to Dustin's question, and where prices will be at when his fishery opens on May 1st. You know, I guess we're looking at more of the same.
More of the same. I think $3.50 to $4 is probably the price that they can expect to fetch at the docks this year. Probably closer to $4. I don't see it exceeding that.
All right. Well, there you have it. Just a quick thanks to Dustin for his question. Appreciate it. And thanks to Jamie for joining me down here on the Portland waterfront. If you have a question for Ask the Editor, please email editor@seafoodsource.com. Again, that's editor@seafoodsource.com. Or tweet the question to Seafood Source. Thank you, and catch you back here next time.